And Travis Head is next in. He desperately wants this wicket.
It's gone! And it's Steve Smith as well.
In the world of cricket, spin bowlers know how to turn a ball. And sometimes, they even turn the batter's head too. The spinning or turning ball is a mystery for the batters. But what is spin bowling? What makes the ball turn or spin? What are the different types of spin? Bowlers might know this art quite well, but do you know that there is a lot of science hidden in it? Watch this video of Explained till the end to know all about it.
When it's come on to bowl.
Broadly, there are two types of bowling in cricket, swing bowling and spin bowling. Click on the link above to watch our video on the science of swing bowling. Spin bowling, as the name suggests, is a technique in which a bowler rotates or spins the ball on its axis while bowling so that it deviates from its original path. But why does the ball change its direction? The ball can either change its direction through the air or after bouncing off the pitch. The reasons for both the deviations are different. Let's first understand how the ball changes its direction after hitting the surface. If a right-arm bowler rotates the ball in a clockwise direction while throwing, the direction of rotation at the downward side of the ball is leftward. When it hits the surface applies the frictional force on it in the opposite direction, that is, rightwards. This makes the ball move rightwards. In cricket terminology, if the right-arm bowler does that, he is known as off-spinner, and if a left-arm bowler balls this way, he is known as a left-arm Chinaman. If a right-arm bowler rotates the ball anti-clockwise, then the direction of rotation at the point of contact is rightwards. The friction acts in the opposite direction, and hence, the ball moves leftwards. This is known as the leg spin. If a right-arm bowler balls this way, then he is known as a leg spinner, and if a left-arm bowler balls this way, then he is known as left-arm orthodox or slow left-arm. Now let's talk about how a ball moves mid-air. Depending upon the direction of rotation, a rotating ball can move mid-air in four different ways. How? Let's find out by playing a game. Let's throw a ball thrice at the same speed and angle and mark the point of contact. First, throw the ball with no spin, then with a forward spin, and once with a backward spin. You will notice that when we throw a ball with forward spin, the ball falls at a distance shorter than it would when the ball is thrown without any rotation. And in the backward spin, the ball will pitch ahead. But why? This is because of the Magnus effect. When a bowler balls with top spin, the air flows from the front of the ball to its back. The ball is spinning in the same direction as the flow of air at the bottom, but it is spinning in a backward direction at the top. Because of the friction between the air and the ball surface, the air is dragged upwards and towards the back on the bottom of the ball. But at the top of the ball, the air and ball are traveling in the opposite direction, and this doesn't let the air cross the ball smoothly. The net result is, air is deflected upwards, and due to Newton's third law, the air exerts an equal and opposite force on the ball, which is downwards. This caused the ball to pitch earlier, and this kind of bowling is known as topspin. On the contrary, when the ball is thrown with a backward spin, then the air at the upper side of the ball moves faster than the air at the lower side. The friction drags the air downwards towards the back of the ball, and due to Newton's third law, the ball moves upwards and hence the ball lifts. This makes the ball land ahead. This kind of ball is generally bowled by a leg spinner and is known as a flipper. Now we know how a forward or backward rotating ball dips or lifts. But what about the drips or sideways movement? Now imagine a ball is thrown with an anti-clockwise rotation. The seam is pointed away from the right-handed batsman and the shine is towards him. As the ball propagates through the air, the speed of the air on the left side gets slower as compared to the right side. That's because the air moves easily on the shiny side, which in turn changes the pressure. The lower the speed, the higher the pressure. This makes the ball drift towards the right of the batsman before pitching. Similarly, If the ball is rotated in the clockwise direction with the seam towards the batsman and the shine away from him, the speed of the air on the left side will be higher. This causes the left side of the ball to be at lower pressure and makes the ball drift towards the left of the batsman before pitching. So now we know that there are simply four types of movements for the ball through the air and two types of movements after pitching. But it is not as simple as it appears. The bowlers have the talent to mix the movement through the air and the movement after pitching, and they can create different combination of drift and spin. This leads to several different types of balls in cricket. Not just that, there are several other factors that affect the spin of the ball, which includes the type of pitch, weather conditions, point of release, wrist position, the role of fingers, way of holding the ball, seam position, and of course the talent of the bowler. Spin bowling requires hours of practice, hard work, and toil to master the skill. And it is as much as science as it is an art. That's all in this episode of Explained. Try to make the ball spin in your next match using these techniques, and don't forget to share this video with the cricket lovers.